Are we taking the drinks?
I got mine. Hey, there's your shirt, boss.
Down here.
Look.
Just follow me.
Follow you where? I got it. So is that the museum up there? Always.
Well, you go to other cities, it's like, even with COVID, it's
barely
packed. But when you pop to Mississippi, and it's always like, wait, is anybody home?
Hey, and the other thing, there's always police presence.
Yep. That's the state park.
So aren't you going to take your photo?
Huh?
There's always a photo opportunity.
Yes.
You may take your mask off to do it. Oh, B, you want to do it by the dragonfly? Then which feet?
I'm on
the stage. Which feet want to do it by? You like the dragonfly?
I like the
museum. So we're at the Mississippi Museum of Natural History, Natural Science. The sun would suddenly open up, some half clearings and giant spider webs would simmer and toss in the light. My father would stand dead in his tracks, gesturing to me to be still, and he would point to a deer further down the path looking at us a brief instant before scampering into the trees. That's very true.
I got your mom to take a picture of me and JJ in front of the deer for you.
Because you follow the arrows.
Come on, JJ.
Jaden. The arrows on the floor. Always a reminder of COVID-19. What's that, JJ?
What kind of fish is that one? Up here.
Gar.
Oh, sorry, I set this on the camera. Oh.
Portrait of a tiger swallowtail.
Wow.
Oh, look at that. What is that, JJ?
Whoa. It's a mosasaurus. It's a mosasaurus.
What is it? Giants of the Amazon.
Ooh, JJ, come here. Start down here.
I lost the child.
The Amazon River Basin drains some 3 million square miles of mountain, tropical forest, savannas, and wetlands.
You might be more interested in this exhibit.
The Pararuku and Pararaba. Is that a parula? They fish them to feed themselves and trade for commodity fish.
You want to hear about the Pararuku?
It's a catfish.
Is it really?
Uh-huh. It's a catfish species. It's huge. Standing. Maximum size 14 feet. Largest fish in the world, the Pararuku. Ruku means red or fire. Interesting. I'm looking at the Pararuku.
It took all four of us to outweigh that fish.
Wait. Are we strong in the drawing car? We're missing like one person.
Wow.
We need one more person.
I wish Webb was here.
Oh, yeah! All that muscle.
Yep. It looks a lot of steps off, so we no longer outweigh those fish.
I need to catch this one, JJ. What do you think? Alrighty, bud. 12 feet. The ruler of the cats. Yes, catfish are just what you really should call them is locals. The Amazon has the largest number of catfish species of any river system. Said to be capable of dragging fishing canoes and knocking people into the water. The powerful Pariba is the largest Amazon catfish species. Wow, that's big.
Only fight back if they can't quickly escape a sticky situation. That said, I have had my share of close calls. Fish use whatever body parts they can as weapons for defense. It hurts. Some bite, others sting. Fish like catfish have spines on their fins, so just handling them has given me cuts and punctures. And then there was this time I went in search of electric eels in the Amazon. To prepare, I took a test shock that gave me a jolt similar to the shock of an electric outlet. An electric eel can deliver a shock 5 times that powerful. There he goes. Thankfully, that test shock was the only one I got on that trip. The cameraman wasn't so lucky. With monster fish, there's also their sheer size to worry about. They have hard heads, rough scales, and heavy, powerful bodies. Trying to hold onto 200 pounds of muscular fish requires real feats of strength. I've been whacked in the legs by a sturgeon and engulfed by a giant stingray. And just being near a pirarucu means worrying about them launching their bodies into the air with a mighty thrash. Getting banged about by monster fish is something I try my best to avoid. Even though I've been bitten, poked, whacked, and shocked over the years, I'm not afraid of monster fish. I respect their power, and I always take precautions to minimize the danger both to myself and to the fish. Sure, it can be dangerous out in the field, but that's all part of the adventure.
I'm going in.
Where are you going, Jason?
I've been working with monster fish for almost 20 years now. So how did I get started? Believe it or not, when I was a kid, my parents wouldn't let me have a pet dog or a pet cat. So I had a
driving
pet
JJ? Animal.
I also spent a lot of time at a creek.
What was that?
House. Growing up in Arizona, being close to water was the best place to be. In some ways, my weakness for the underdog got me into fish. They aren't as cute or cuddly as pandas, or as obviously majestic as lions. But monster fish are pretty awesome. I like all the fish that I encounter. Freshwater rays for their curiosity. Sturgeon for their steady, ageless approach to life. Paddlefish for looking so strange, ancient, and ungainly. Taimen for their beauty, aggressiveness, and agility. And alligator are
monsters down under. I've seen this guy on television.
The swordfish one is definitely one I wouldn't want to come up with.
Mm-hmm.
a large tooth sawfish. Freshwater sawfish. 21 feet. By long and rounded like a snake? Yes or no?
Beneath the surface of Thailand's Mekong River, so they're the largest freshwater fish.
It actually is rounded like a snake. Does it have barbells, appendages that look like whiskers? How many does it have? Count them. Now find the number 6. Mm-hmm.
Good job.
How big, look, JJ, it's about to tell you what it is. So how big is its dorsal fin compared to its body size? Small, medium, or large?
Small.
Click on small. How is it colored, JJ?
Jaded.
JJ, how's it colored?
It's purple.
Look, now use your hands to throw it back in the water. Ready? Oh. There you go.
You did it.
It's a Wells catfish. The Wells catfish is a formidable predator and one of the biggest freshwater fish out there. Their records have been growing up to 16 feet long and close to 700 pounds. Native to Eastern Europe and Asia, the Wells catfish was introduced into Spanish waters in the 1970s. With warm water, plenty of food, and no natural predators, this fish, the Durango Fishery Center, produces about 500,000 murrey cod every year.
Oh, look at all those we got explored, JJ. All those freshwater lakes and streams
to go fishing in.
Oh, come here, JJ. American paddlefish. 77 feet long. Ancient, appearing in fossil records. Their unusual paddle-shaped snout or rostrum is covered with electrosensory receptors. Cool.
Zara, do you want to look in the microscope?
Fish growth marks. Alligator gar. Yes, it is.
Look at it.
Oh, no, look! It has a small little gar.
Almost should have cleaned it up and kept the
scales.
Good reason. The regional Cajun French name for gar is poisson d'amour, or armored fish.
Look, you see his armor just right over there.
Oh, whoa, look at it.
That was a baby I caught. So we got a flathead catfish, alligator gar. And a lake sturgeon. Golden mushroom, the tiger of the river.